Outgoing Shelby County Mayor Mark Luttrell is a father and a grandfather, so it's no surprise that he spearheaded an effort to do more than simply punish juveniles who commit crimes.
And as he prepares to leave office, we wanted to take one more look at the goals and the progress of the county's Juvenile Assessment Center. Mayor Luttrell, welcome back to Live Tonight. Always good to have you here.
Alex, Mary Beth, thank you all so much for the time.
Our pleasure.
Should also point out that you spent an entire career in the criminal justice system. So in addition to your love and understanding of young people, you also know that sometimes jail teaches them worse things, right?
So, Mayor, with that in mind, where do we stand with the Juvenile Assessment Center?
Well, first of all, it's just wonderful that we're getting to this point where we have an assessment center that's forthcoming. We had a soft opening last week where we really kind of introduced to the public exactly what we're about. I'd start by saying it's not a part of the criminal justice system. What we're attempting to do is to, in every way possible, where we can, is to avoid children matriculating through the criminal justice system. So anything we can do to kind of shortstop that and get them involved in some type of help programs that keep them out of the criminal justice system, then that's progress. And that's what our assessment is.
In the long run, Mayor, what does that mean? What can that potentially do,
well,
not only for that child, but for the community?
What it does, first of all, we were able to get legislation in the General Assembly that gives law enforcement the prerogative of diverting them to the assessment center,
okay,
as opposed to either sending them home or sending them to jail.
Okay.
Now they have the opportunity to take them to the assessment center. And at the assessment center, introduced them to an array of family services that involve not just the juvenile, but also parents and family members, to give them the assistance that they might need in dealing with whatever the trouble might be that that youth is experiencing.
So give us an example of what kinds of criteria might come into play to determine this child needs to go here. This would be better for the child, the family, and the community.
Well, first of all, that assessment would be made not by law enforcement, would be made by mental health and public health
to see if there are extenuating circumstances.
Yeah. And there are an array of partners that will be working with us on everything from anger management to mental health issues, to environmental concerns within the community, to parental relationships, to any number of specialty areas that we have across the community that provide services. We now, with the assessment center, kind of bring them under an umbrella with contractual arrangements to call them in to deal with whatever the diagnosis, if you will, is for the child that's being addressed. The idea is to try to quickly get the child and the family coordinated in some type of attempt to arrest that wayward behavior.
So very quickly, Mayor, before we have to wrap up, how do you think we leave juvenile court today? Because there have been so many issues, the feds, of course, over the federal government getting involved, kind of looking things over as well. Where do you think we stand
today? Well, let me make it clear that the assessment center is not part of the juvenile court.
Exactly.
Right.
Juvenile court has a number of issues that they're addressing, both with the Department of Justice and also with their facility. And those are things that really must be addressed quickly, because there are some dire needs when it comes to facility maintenance and some operational issues that need to be addressed and needs to be done quickly.
We are almost out of time, but one thing you're most proud of?
Most proud of what we've been able to do with pre-kindergarten and early childhood development programs. And as you say, I've been in the criminal justice system, and I know that criminal behavior begins at a very young age.
Yep.
Anything we can do to arrest that behavior early on is a victory for our society.
Thank you for your years of service.
Appreciate
thank you
being
all.
Here.
It's
we
been a pleasure.
You.